already seen a few different techniques for how to multiply quickly. Some of those techniques include quarter squares, using logarithms or a slide rule, and that method of prostophoresis, which involves arc cosine. So yeah, there's a ton of different techniques that I can use to multiply two numbers quickly. But what if I could already multiply quickly, but I wanted to divide quickly? What if I wanted to calculate 1 divided by b? Well, we can use Newton's method to do this. Now, how are we going to use Newton's method? Well, Newton's method is really a trick for finding zeros of a function. So if I want to approximate 1 divided by b, the reciprocal of b, what I really want to find is some function where that number is a zero of the function. Newton's method will help me approximate that zero and consequently help me approximate 1 over b. There's a ton of different choices that are possible for such a function. Well, here's one choice, the function f of x equals 1 over x minus b. And let's just check, yeah, if I evaluate this function at 1 over b, that's 1 over 1 over b minus b. But 1 over 1 over b, the reciprocal of the reciprocal of b is just b, and b minus b is in fact 0. So this function f does have 1 over b as a 0. Now let's apply Newton's method. So how are we going to do this? Here's the formula for Newton's method, right? This is iterative formula. My next guess is my old guess minus this fraction, the function evaluated at my old guess divided by the derivative evaluated at my old guess. And when this works, it's marching me closer to a zero of the function. And here's the good function for doing division. This function has a zero at 1 over b. So if I can get closer and closer to a zero of this function, I'm actually computing 1 over b, which is what I want to do. So let's try to rewrite this formula just by using this. And the first step here is to differentiate this. So let's differentiate this. Well, I'm differentiating with respect to x, so the derivative of 1 over x is minus 1 over x squared, and the b here is just a constant, so I have to include it. So there's the derivative of f. Now I'll use that to try to make this Newton's method formula look a little bit nicer. So x sub n plus 1 is x sub n minus the function evaluated at x sub n, which is 1 over x sub n minus b, divided by the derivative evaluated at x sub n, which is minus 1 over x sub n squared. Now, to kill off this denominator, let's multiply by minus x sub n squared divided by minus x sub n squared. That's just a sneaky version of 1, but it manages to kill off the denominator. Simplify this a bit. I've got x sub n. I've got minus x sub n squared times 1 over x sub n. That leaves me with a minus x sub n. And I've got a negative b negative x sub n squared. That's a plus b x sub n squared. I'm subtracting this, so I've got x sub n plus x sub n, that's 2 x sub n's, minus b x sub n squared, and I'll factor out an x sub n. So x sub n times 2 minus b x sub n, and what I've got here now is an iterative formula that, at least when it works, applying this iterative formula is going to move me closer and closer to 1 over b. But this formula doesn't involve division. It only involves multiplying and subtracting. So this is a way to approximate 1 over b without ever dividing, right? Just multiplying and subtracting over and over again. We'll make this even more concrete. Let's set b equals 7 so I can try to approximate 1 over 7. So here we go. B will be 7, so we're trying to approximate 1/7 using Newton's method. So I make an initial guess. I'll make my initial guess 1/10. That'll make some of the arithmetic work out a little bit more reasonably. And I'm going to start with this initial guess, and I'll use this formula that we just derived to improve this initial guess to a hopefully better guess. So I take my original guess, 1/10, multiply it by 2 minus b is 7 times my previous guess of 1/10. Now I can calculate this. This is 1/10 times, instead of 2, I'll write 20/10. And instead of 7 times a tenth, I'll write 7/10. I got 20 minus 7/10, so that's 13/10. So 1/10 times 13/10, that's 13/100. And that's a slightly better guess as to the value of 1/7. But I can now repeat this process using this formula again. So I'll get a better guess here, x sub 2, by starting with my previous guess, which is 13/100. multiplying that by 2 minus 7 times my previous guess of 1/13. Now I can calculate what this is. So 1/13, instead of 2, I'll write 200/100, that's another name for 2, minus, instead of 7 times 13, I'll multiply that out, I'll get 91/100. Now 200 minus 91, that's 109/100 times 1/13, and 13 times 109 is 1,417, and 100 times 100 is 10,000. So that's an even better approximation to the actual value of 1/7. And I could repeat the process again. The arithmetic gets, you know, sort of awful, but the point here isn't so much, you know, that, you know, I can actually do this on paper, that I would want to do this on paper, but that this procedure only involves adding, subtracting, and multiplying, and yet it ends up calculating a division problem. Well, how close are we to the actual value of 1/7? 1/7 is about 0.142857, and it keeps on going. So yeah, we're doing really quite well. I mean, 0.14 is a pretty good guess as to the actual value of 1/7. This method has a name. So this technique usually goes by the name Newton-Raphson division, and we just saw that it works for finding reciprocals, but if you can find reciprocals and you can multiply, you can do division in general. Right? If you wanted to approximate 3/7 using this technique, well, you just point out that 3/7 is 3 times 1/7. Right? And imagine that you can multiply, add, subtract, but the division is hard. Okay, well, a moment ago we approximated 1/7. Right? We approximated 1/7 to be about 1,417 over 10,000. This was the second stage in the approximation. And 3 times 1,417 is 4,251 over 10,000, which isn't so far off of 3/7, right? The point, though, is that, you know, it's division, but it's division that only involves repeated adding, subtracting, and multiplying.